team started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Dick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Xavier Musketeers and the Colorado State Rams.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of the other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Rams could be in for a tough one tonight, Dick. What do they have to do if they want to have a chance to win tonight?
Well, partner, here's what I see as the key to the game. Number one, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his club. Next, hand the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if we can get their big man in foul trouble. And lastly, execute defensively. Don't get caught going for the big steals or the big blocks.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Fed the low block. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Cross court. Crockett handles the feed. For two. Perfectly executed. That's good defense, a steal on the inside.
Oh, what a way to force the turnover. Great anticipation by the post player.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. He shoots from the top of the key. He gets that one to fall. He'll regroup the offense. Here's the offensive drop step on a low block, but better defense swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Oh, what a strip, Brad.
Defensively down on a low block, and there's a steal.
Oh, terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Crockett handles the pass. Inside. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. Turn around, fadeaway. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid is responding in a positive way.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Number 32 with the fake.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Goes up for two.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
On the outside. He attempts the three, way off target.
This defender is resilient, still applying pressure.
Tries for two, can't get the shot to go. He keeps the dribble as they reset. Looking to move it around the perimeter. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Makes the foul shot. Gave it up in the paint. Puts it up, looking for contact. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a bad pass, right to the defender. Shows patience, waiting for the reset.
Dump it inside.
For the bucket, and in and out. He cleans the glass. Inside. There's the fake. He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
receives the pass. Trying to pack it inside. Here's a double team. Fakes it and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Well, some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession. Look at that spacing.
Riggs receives the ball. There they come with a double team to stop it. Goes up for two. Drains the shot.
Play that back for me one time.
Shot clock is dead. Looking for a good shot. The shot drops and the foul.
Great concentration on the shot, Brad.
He is going to the line. Good. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
At halftime, the Musketeers are down by four. Xavier carelessly gave away a lot of possessions by turning the ball over.
Their coaching staff must be livid right now. The amount of extra opportunities they're giving away is just absurd.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. The crowd loves this young man.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. Looking for the foul. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot. Pump fakes. Now the turnaround jumper. And off the mark. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. The center gets the pass. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
Gave it up. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Perfectly executed. Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
Postel is animated and ready to go.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
Easy one. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
They move it into the front court. And he'll kick it back outside. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop. Tries for two. And he missed. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Cross court. Picks off the pass. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
They go back in front by two. He shoots from the top of the key. Rims out.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
For the bucket. Up. Easy one. It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Working at a perimeter. Looking for a good shot. They work it around the perimeter.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He intercepts it. Goes up for two.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
Shot clock is dead. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here. Well, Dick, it's obvious to me that they are starting to heat things up right now.
I'll tell you one thing. They're getting good shots, and they're making them count. They're in a groove, baby. And when they're in a groove, that court looks like an unbelievable Atlantic Ocean instead of a teapot.
And yet another foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
And the clock stop with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He makes the front end of the one and one. He misses the second.
Timeout's called on the floor. This is where the true players come to play. It's crunch time, baby.
Seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
Manning is trying to get the fans involved now.
Hey, Brad, I think he wants the crowd backing him up on this next possession.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, I tell you, when this game round, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job.
Colorado State played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.